Hey everyone, this is Roy with Cape Fear Family Law. I hope everyone's doing well. Today I'm here to talk to you about incorporating separation agreements. So let's say that you've worked out a separation agreement with your spouse, that you may have done it with attorneys, you may have done it without attorneys, and now there's this question of incorporation. So what exactly does that mean? Incorporation is the process where a separation agreement, which is a contract between two parties, is merged into a court order. So what most commonly happens with separation agreements is you have this separation agreement that's a contract between you and your spouse. And then when your final divorce decree is entered by the court, a question is whether or not that should be incorporated into the divorce decree. There are a lot of issues you have to consider if you're thinking about incorporating a separation agreement into a divorce decree or any other court order. So we have to understand what exactly the law around incorporation is. Incorporated separation agreements are going to be considered consent judgments by the court. So the law concerning consent judgments can guide us as far as what is required to incorporate a separation agreement. For example, there was a case in North Carolina where, you know, the parties had actually previously agreed that they would incorporate an agreement into a court order. But then at the time when it came to actually incorporate the agreement, one of the parties objected to it. And the Court of Appeals said that because at the time a court order would need to be incorporated, he didn't agree, it could not be incorporated, even though he had previously agreed before that it would be. There isn't much case law on the exact issue of incorporating separation agreements into court judgments. The one reference to this from the Court of Appeals is actually just in a footnote of a case. It's Kavanaugh v. Kavanaugh. So while this was just a footnote in a case, it does provide a lot of information to help us think about what's actually required. So one of the first things the court notes is that when facing the possibility of incorporating a separation agreement into a court order, a judge may actually be able to refuse incorporating a separation agreement into a court order if they find that the result would not be equitable. The court also noted the possibility that in a separation agreement, the parties could agree to incorporate, and then at the time of actually incorporating it into the court order, the one party could object and, based on the agreement in the contract, still incorporate the agreement over the party's objection. So it seems like there might be a little conflict, but what will be noted is that would still likely require a breach of contract claim. So now that we have a better understanding of what the law surrounding incorporating separation agreements in North Carolina is, we can start to weigh the pros and cons of choosing to incorporate or not incorporate. So the pros for incorporating a separation agreement would be that, to start, it makes it easier to enforce. When you're incorporating the separation agreement, it becomes a court order. It's enforceable by the court's power of contempt, whereas if you choose not to incorporate a separation agreement, it's only going to be enforceable by making a breach of contract claim, and it's going to take longer and be more difficult. The other pro of choosing to incorporate an agreement and make it into a court order is that people generally are going to take a court order more seriously than a contract. The court order is going to be signed by a judge and have the specter of judicial power behind it. People tend to treat court orders differently than they do, you know, everyday contracts, which is what a separation agreement is at the end of the day. So even given the ease of enforcement, there are a few downsides to incorporating a separation agreement that you need to consider when making this decision. The biggest one is going to be that the remedies between, you know, enforcing a contract and enforcing a court order are going to be a lot different because of the law. Our advice to avoid the issue of trying to figure out, you know, what are the remedies now that this is no longer just a normal contract but a court order. If faced with the question of whether or not you would want to incorporate a separation agreement, it's always better to simply have that drafted as a consent order between the parties. Everyone will be clear from the start about how it will be enforced, and it'll be written with the powers of the court in mind and what the laws of North Carolina are. That way you avoid the problems of having to try and figure out what you agreed to when you did your separation agreement, and what the court is going to do now that it's incorporated into a court order. So everyone, thanks for watching. I hope this was helpful. If you've got questions about incorporating a separation agreement or you have history with this issue, tell us about it in the comments below. We'd love to hear from you, and don't forget to like and subscribe.